Hey guys, it's Hannah. Welcome back to my channel. And today I have a special video to be reacting to. I was supposed to be graduating this spring from college, and because of all of the virus and all that's going on, the ceremony got canceled, and there's been like virtual ceremonies here and there with a bunch of celebrities, but I wanted to react to BTS's speeches towards us graduates this year. I missed the when it was broadcasted live, so I figured I might as well record my reaction, especially since I am part of the class that's not going to get to experience the in-person ceremonies. I did get to do my ceremonies for my high school and my junior college graduations, but this is, unless I go for my master's, the last time I'll ever be graduating. So it's been a rough time for me to get over the hump, especially since I got shuffed away from my friends and athletics and just, okay, you're an adult now, have fun. So it's been rough to adjust to it, and I like how one of the things that brought me comfort was K-pop, so one of the groups that helped me through college is BTS, and since they're doing a speech, I wanted to see and hear what they have to say and stuff like that. And I also thought it'd be fun to wear my cap while I do this. I'm not wearing it now because I wanted to show you what it looks like. I have it. I designed it myself. It's based off of Eric Nam's lyrics for Congratulations, although I did change it to I'm instead of your. And the colors are 17 colors because they're my babies. But I thought it was fitting because at the time I was over college and I wanted to leave, but then all of a sudden I got told to go and then I was started missing it, which is kind of ironic that I was ready to leave and when I was told to leave I can't. So we'll wear this and we'll get right into the video.
Hello, we are
BTS
and this is RM, third class of 2020. It's been a strange year so far, but you made it. Today, we might not have flowers, and we might not have graduation caps.
I do, but
what we do have is possibly the most special graduation ceremony in history. Never before have so many gathered to celebrate a graduating class for their achievements and their dreams. You could be watching us from your bed or from your living room, alone or with somebody. Wherever you are, you will all soon be breaking out of one world, soar into another. 10 years ago, it snowed really hard on the day of my middle school graduation. I remember that day clearly because I took a picture with my friends and kept it as my messenger profile for the rest of my school years.
That's some commitment. I couldn't keep a picture that long.
On that day, I was just a boy who had closed just one chapter, ready to pen another. And I remember that feeling. It's really thrilling, breathtaking. It was a moment I felt most like me myself, a feeling I wanted to hold on to forever. So, as a fellow individual in his 20s, all the way from Seoul, Korea, I want to say congratulations.
Thank you.
We're very excited for what lies ahead of you. Regardless of where or how far you are, we hope our stories today can give you some sort of comfort, hope, and maybe an even bit of inspiration.
He had to be pointing at J-Hope.
네, 안녕하세요. 방탄소년단 정국입니다. 여러분, 졸업 축하드립니다. 남준이 형과는 다르게 제 졸업 사진은 유튜브 방탄밤에 기록되어 있습니다. 고등학교 시작과 끝에는 항상 멤버들이 있었고요. 언제 이렇게 다 커서 졸업을 하게 됐냐며 형들이 옆에서 막 축하해주고 졸업식 마치고 다 같이 짜장면을 먹었던 기억이 있습니다. 그런데 저도 최근에 영상을 한번 봤는데 이런 생각이 들더라고요. 정말 저 아이가 커서 내가 된 걸까? 남준이 형은 졸업식장의 소년이 형 자신인 것 같다고 했는데 저는 좀 다르게 먼 길을 걸은 것 같습니다. 끊임없이 걸은 것 같은데 뭐 그럼에도 항상 새롭게 배워 나가는 게 있더라고요. 그래서 지금의 저는 나를 믿고 멤버들을 믿고 세상을 믿으면서 지금 이 자리에 멤버들과 함께 서 있습니다. 그러니까 여러분들도 앞으로 여러분들을 위해서 한 걸음씩 나아가고 끊임없이 달려가셨으면 좋겠습니다.
I will try my best,
Jungkook. 네, 안녕하세요. 방탄소년단 진입니다. 저는 조금 다른 졸업식을 기억합니다. 20살 무렵 저는 아직 데뷔도 하지 않았고 이제 막 대학 입학을 앞둔 평범한 졸업생이었습니다. 그때 저는 성인이 되는 것이 두려웠어요. 낯선 세상으로 나아가는 것이 겁나서 말도 행동도 모든 게 조심스러웠고요. 때로는 앞서가는 친구들이 신경 쓰이고 조급한 마음이 들 때도 있었습니다. 남들의 걸음에 맞추려 애를 써보기도 했지만 숨이 가빴고 곧 그것은 저의 속도가 아니라는 걸 깨달았습니다. 하지만 그때마다 저를 지탱해 준 건 천천히 가자는 저 스스로의 다짐이었습니다. 느려도 나만의 속도로 걷자고 선택한 거죠. 그래서 저는 걸음이 느린 대신 남들보다 시간을 조금 더 들이는 습관을 갖게 됐습니다. 춤 연습을 할 때도 멤버들보다 며칠 앞서 준비를 시작하곤 하죠. 여러분도 새롭게 시작해야 한다는 부담감에 또 낯선 환경과 마주하며 어디로 가야 할 줄 모르겠다면 조급해하지 말고 잠시 멈추어 보세요. 어쩌면 지금 이 순간은 우리에게 주어진 기회일지도 모르겠습니다. 여유를 갖고 느려도 한 걸음 한 걸음 성실히 내딛는다면 예전에 몰랐던 소중한 것들이 보일 겁니다. 그것들이 여러분에게 말을 걸어올지도 모릅니다.
안녕하세요. 슈가입니다. 요즘 저는 한참 달리다가 넘어진 것 같은 그런 기분입니다. 그리고 다시 일어나 주위를 둘러보니 주변엔 아무것도 없고 서만에 가져버린 것만 같습니다. 멋진 매듭도 새로운 시작도 못하고 많이 답답해하고 있을 여러분들 모두 겁내거나 불안해하지 않으셨으면 좋겠습니다. 시작과 끝, 끝과 시작은 연결되어 있으니까요. 섬이기 때문에 할 수 있는 것들도 있습니다. 오로지 나 자신에 집중하는 것, 그리고 나 자신의 틀을 깨보는 겁니다.
That's good advice.
한없이 초라하고 작게만 느껴지던 한 사람이 얼마나 큰 꿈을 꾸고 또 얼마나 큰 그림을 그리고 그 한계 없는 가능성에 한 발짝씩 다가가고 있을지 우리가 다시 만나게 될 때 꼭 보여주셨으면 좋겠습니다. 그러기 위해서는 통제 불가능한 것에서 손을 떼고 통제 가능한 것부터 손을 대셨으면 합니다. 저도 그리고 여러분들도 앞으로 살아가면서 수도 없이 통제 불가능한 상황에 놓이실 것입니다. 우리가 유일하게 통제할 수 있는 건 우리 자신뿐입니다. 통제 가능한 것부터 시작해보면 어떨까요? 여러분들의 가능성은 무한합니다. 저도 방탄소년단이 될 줄 꿈에도 몰랐습니다. 감사합니다.
So
여러분 안녕하세요. 지민입니다. 먼저 졸업을 진심으로 축하드립니다. 그런데 사실은 축하보다는 걱정이 앞서는 것 같아요. 어디 아프지는 않은지 혹시 많이 힘든 건 아닌지 그리고 모든 게 엉망이 되어버린 것 같은 지금 이 시간을 잘 견디고 있는 건지 또 요즘 여러분들의 뭔가 마음이 괜찮은지 걱정이 많이 됩니다. 모두들 잘 지내고 계셨으면 좋겠지만 만약 조금이라도 괜찮지 않다면 저희가 온 마음을 다해 위로해드리고 싶습니다. 윤기 형이 섬 속에 갇힌 것 같다고 이야기했지만 그래도 절대 포기하시지는 않았으면 좋겠습니다. 여기 한국이라는 나라, 그리고 서울이라는 도시에 나를 이해해주는 누군가가 있다는 점을 꼭 기억해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다. 우리 모두 각자 다른 환경에 살고 있고 다른 상황에 처해 있지만 적어도 이 순간만큼은 우리 다 같이 괜찮다라고 서로 위로해 주었으면 좋겠습니다.
안녕하세요. 여러분들의 희망, 제이홉입니다. 저도 여러분들과 다르지 않습니다. 노래를 만들고 춤을 추다 보면 막다른 골목에 다다를 때가 있죠. 머릿속이 새하얗게 변해서 더 이상 앞으로 나가기 어려워지기도 하고요. 작업을 하면서 수없이 겪는 일입니다. 그럴 때 그래도 딱 한 번만 더 라는 생각이 저를 일으켜 세울 때가 많습니다. 나 자신을 한번 믿어보는 거죠. 완벽하지 않아도 처음보단 두 번째, 두 번째보단 세 번째 더 나아지는 것을 보며 주저앉지 않기를 잘했다고 생각하게 됩니다. 여러분도 지금의 상황이든 아니면 전공이나 직업이든 내가 선택한 길로 나아가다 보면 과연 그게 올바른 선택이었는지 내가 잘 하고 있는지 이대로 가면 실패하는 건 아닌지 끊임없이 의심이 들곤 할 겁니다. 그럴 땐 꼭 기억하세요. 내 인생을 이끄는 것은 바로 나 자신이란 것을요. 그리고 주문을 외우는 겁니다. 할 수 있어. You got it. 나는 잘 할 수 있어.
He's so cute.
누구보다 나는 잘 해낼 거야. 바로 이렇게요.
This smile makes me feel so much better. Oh.
안녕하세요, 비입니다. 아주 특별한 날 졸업을 축하합니다. 많은 시간이 지나 오늘을 되돌아보면 어떤 기억으로 남을까요? 지금 모두가 쉽지 않은 현실과 싸우고 있지만 여러분들도 사진 한 장, 글 한 줄 남기며 이 순간을 기억해보면 좋겠습니다. 그때는 이랬지, 뭐 2020년 6월은 이랬지, 그리고 현재의 모습에 비추어 다시 바라보는 거죠. 사실 저는 노래와 춤의 재능을 타고나지도 않았고 끈기가 있는 편도 아니었습니다. 사실 친구들보다 뭐 부족했고 시작도 늦었지만 춤추고 노래하는 즐거움에 푹 빠지게 됐었죠. 뭐 그 즐거움은 저를 꾸준히 노력하게 했고요. 그렇게 이 자리까지 왔습니다. 지금 졸업을 앞두고 앞으로 무엇을 해야 할지 뭐 잘 보이지 않아 힘든 분들이 있다면 한번 여러분의 진심에 기대어 보세요. 지금은 조금 힘들어도 그 끝자락 어딘가에 기회와 행운이 기다리고 있지 않을까요? 저는 그렇게 믿고 있습니다. 그런 의미에서 저는 오늘을 기억해 두겠습니다. 오늘 비록 저의 졸업식은 아니지만 많은 시간이 지나 이 날을 좋은 기억으로 떠올릴 수 있도록 노력하겠습니다. 그리고 언젠가 여러분의 이야기도 들을 수 있기를 바랍니다.
Dear class of 2020, I hope our stories reach you all today. To be really, really frank, we still feel very unsure and unsettled as we speak, just like that day we left the school gates for the last time on graduation day. Some say we have achieved so many things, but we stand no different from any other youth in their 20s. Our graduation caps still pressed to our heads and awkwardly peering into the face of reality. The recent unforeseen events completely changed our plans, and the sense of loss and anxiety we felt then are still with us today. The fear of an obscure future as our daily lives turn upside down is a moment of realization of the self, the realization of what makes me a true me, myself. As just musicians, we are pulling ourselves together by making music. We write songs, we produce, and we practice as we think about the people we love. And it connects to the world during such difficult times. And with music, we hope we can bring you smiles and courage.
We do, more than you know.
And V just mentioned memos and the photographs. For us, our way of remembering and communicating is to make music. For you, it could be anything. In our music, and in our hearts, and in the time that we break out of ourselves, we're alone, but also together. We may be seeing each other through just a camera and this small screen, but I know your future will bloom to something much bigger and magnificent.
I hope so.
Graduates, friends, family, faculty, today, you stand with us the largest graduating class in history.
I mean, he's not wrong, technically.
Are they
going to throw their caps?
Congratulations, class of 2020!
I feel like I should throw my... What the... Really good speeches. That's not fair. I can't do speeches like that. I would mumble and jumble all the time. Like, each of them gave like such like nice advice. Most of them were about like finding yourself and making sure you're okay. because we were in such a we were in a world that like you had to keep going and going and going and going. You didn't have time to like stop and care for yourself. But now that the world is on pause, you can take that time to bring it back to yourself and make sure you're okay. But at the same time, because your life is on hold or stuff ended all of a sudden, the anxiety came to you all of a sudden out of nowhere. So it's like you have to like pause yourself as well. But like I've been wanting to be a pop culture journalist, like K-pop journalist. I've had a few opportunities to go through with it, but it's kind of hard to continue with that with everything going on. But I'm not gonna stop me. I'm gonna keep trying to do my best, start applying places, especially once everything is starting to come back up, which it looks like it slowly is. And like, as you said, like we are technically the biggest graduating class in the world ever, and we're gonna be going down in history books like every year. Same old, people had their graduation ceremony. Nothing big ever happened, it was just the same, but now people are gonna remember the class of 2020. We're not the regular, we came, we did our school, we graduated, move on. We overcame a lot. Like, we had to finish school from our houses, like, especially those who were exchange students or, like, internationals. They were, like, sent back home, or they had trouble with, like, visas and stuff like that. Or even if they were in your own country, you still had to go back home. Couldn't stay in dorms. Or if you had off-campus housing, you could stay there, but it was hard to get money to pay for it. Like, there were so many elements involved, and people overcame it and did school and did what they had to do to graduate, which is a lot of work to do online. I don't know how many of you guys have really had to experience it, but it's not easy, especially when you're doing things that require electronics and internet and things that might not be accessible everywhere. So it can be super hard. And to all those who didn't have it but made it work, I'm proud of each and every one of you, because like I said, it's not easy. Like, I know I had trouble with programs. Like, I had to do graphic design and journalism stuff from a distance, and the programs did not like cooperating at all. So I was worried that I couldn't get things turned in on time. Luckily, everything turned out for the best, and I get to walk across the stage. That's not gonna happen. I think I was just still in like mode wise. But like, yeah, like, we're going to be remembered that we overcame the problems that we're faced in front of us. Like, I swear, year 2020 is going to be its own history class. Like, people are talking about it's going to be a chapter in history classes. No, it's going to be its own textbook. It's going to be its own course. Like, it's going to be taught. Like, every week we are going over a week that happened in 2020 or something like that. Or, like, every week is a month or something like that. Because we're only just now into the sixth month, and so much has happened. It's ridiculous. But anyways, that was me reacting to BTS's commencement speech towards all the 2020 graduates around the world. I congratulate all my fellow graduates, whether it be from high school, college, like if you got your master's, like, props to you. Every graduation is an accomplishment. Be proud of it and embrace what you have, and just be ready to look forward to the next chapter of your life. Take your time to reflect on what you did in your past and like how you can evolve and be better, because that's really all we can do right now. And I hope the best for all of you. But anyways, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.